affecting a part of the brain drain, like you said earlier. But let's look at some of the hindrances to investment in the education sector.
Right.
You know, there was a poll conducted some time back where, you know, last year actually, where a lot of private equity players said they'd want to invest in the education sector. But there are a lot of hindrances and ambiguity on the regulatory side, which they said is are the biggest sort of obstacles to their investment here.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? Do you see things changing there?
We see things sort of improving. I think there are still challenges in terms of very clear-cut structure which the government and current regulation has set out for particularly the higher education, and a little, you know, less on the K-12 side, so that the institutions have to be set up as a not-for-profit, you know, structure, societies or trust. Where we see again a private sector already taking a big role, you know, in providing education on K-12 side is, you know, by taking over, let's say, management contracts, or, you know, setting up, providing faculty support, teacher training, you know, providing all the other peripheral parts of the education value chain in terms of testing, assessment, coaching, and even, as I said earlier, the finishing school, you know, type of concept. So I would say from a pure investment perspective, a large part of education sector is still sort of challenging, you know, in terms of current regulations to be able to invest, you know, but there are structures which have emerged, and, you know, we are also looking at actually in some of those opportunities, you know, where we can participate in a legal, you know, a legally available manner.
Right, Rajesh. Rajesh, let's just try and get a fix on you know, the education space in terms of attractiveness for investment.
Yeah.
You identified this is one of the core area for investments for you. What do you see in terms of growth in education vis-a-vis other sectors? I mean, how do you see it outperforming that you would like to focus on it? What are the kind of return on investment expectations that you believe the sector would be able to deliver, or, you know, enterprises in the sector will deliver? And what kind of time do you see, you know, returns coming in?
Right. So let me just sort of, you know, level set the context here. If we look at the education industry today, it's about, in the private domain, it's about $50 to $60 billion of spend which is happening in education. Large part of it is going into, again, K-12 and the higher education side, to roughly about 70 to 75%, and the remaining 25% already goes into sectors which are, you know, easily sort of available for private sector initiatives, you know, for-profit organizations, around entire peripheral activities which happen around the core education. Add to that another about $30 billion, which is, you know, kind of spent by the government on providing education through various initiatives. You know, there are more than 1 million schools in the government sector today. However, a large part of that $30 billion spent, you know, just goes towards the salaries, you know, for teachers. And what we see as a big sort of, you know, a problem today is that there are about 1 million schools in the government sector, about 70,000 to 75,000 schools in the private sector. But the number of students which are going into the private sector schools is disproportionately higher as compared to the number of schools. Almost 40% of students go into a private sector school, and I would say it's more of an aspirational. Also, if you look at you know, today's large population, I think education is kind of considered as a ticket, you know, to success. So if you have good quality education, you know, you are kind of assured of a reasonable lifestyle, you know, down the line. So people would want to, you know, naturally want to get educated, you know, go through the system.
Right.
So the growth in the sector is humongous. You know, I would say the sector as a whole is growing at a 15 to 20% growth. But, you know, right now what we are focused on is identifying areas which can deliver growth in excess of 40%, 35%, and we are seeing certain, you know, segments like that. Secondly, you know, we have seen consistently the government has been increasing their you know, budgets allocation towards education. And we also see some of our portfolio companies, in fact, are participating in terms of, you know, taking a pie out of that government spend. So even that is, you know, an opportunity to be able to participate in that $30 billion which is set aside for the government spend.
Right.
You know, take a small percentage out of that, you know, which is already flowing into various private players. You know, be it in the form of ICT, multimedia in schools. You know, government is setting aside a huge amount towards vocational training, and they are inviting private players to the project. You know, train these students, get them, you know, find the jobs for them, and then get paid.
Right. What kind of returns would you? 40% growth is huge, but yeah. In terms of,
I'm saying 40% growth is for certain segments of the education sector. On sector as a whole is, you know, roughly in the range of 15% to 18%.
Right.
The kind of returns that again, you know, varies from different segments, different parts of the value chain.
Right.
But nothing, you know, less than about 25% to 30%. So that's in returns in excess of 25-30%. Some of the models in education, which are again around the peripheral, you know, area around the core education, are actually quite less capital intensive. So you can set up, and a huge amount of, you know, entrepreneurship is happening there. A lot of vibrancy, you know, people tying up as a franchisee to a large national education player, and you know, participating in that.
Great.
In education, a little bit of technical trouble coming in there, but no trouble coming in for the markets for sure. You've got the markets holding on to their gains, 1% higher for the Sensex and the Nifty. You've got the global markets, the Asian markets doing very well as well. China is now up nearly 1.5%. All that will be carried forward through buy or sell over the next 1 hour, and most importantly, your queries answered on whether you should be buying into this market, should you be selling into the gains. All that coming up with Manvi and Ashu on the other side. Thanks for watching Fundamentals as always.